The next team is the team from Germany. Are they here already? Team Sensible? Okay, we're a bit ahead of schedule, so I'll expect them in a few minutes, so we'll be back. All right, I see that the team from Germany has arrived in the meantime. Welcome, Team Sensible.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to our translation pitch about GFM-based healthcare. We are the team Sensible from the University Applied Life Science, Kaiserslautern. At the CAPTA medical application, we use a microstructure sensor system, and we think the system is by adapted a very big capability of use for use, and is very small. Our size is 200 per 200 micrometer, and we catch also small intubable. And one of our benefit is dozens of different makers can be measured on and the same ship. You can see here our ship design. On this size is the sensitive aware. And on this size is the reference aware. And a good one is very fast and easy screening for thousands of diseases in minutes. And we have also a very low limit of detection. And another good benefit is we can use two different methods. On the other side, the field effect detection, and we can also use the impedance sensing. They are time-dependent readout, and we have also multiple transducer effects leading to higher selectivity and improved sensitivity because we can use two different methods. And also a good one is we can control the ship before we test. Is it work or is it not work? And then can we say, is the ship wrong or our measure is wrong? And the next CAPTA is our future version. And we finished device could fit in a small form factor. For example, an electric brazier.
This could be the shape of our medical device. So that's about the same size and works with battery power. It will not be a Razer, but it could be a handheld device like this. And nevertheless, it is able to screen thousands of different diseases on one chip, or hundreds with easily exchangeable set of chip. And while that, at the same time, it is cheaper than other things. Our industrial potential is that we use graphene oxide based sensor, and we use a superior graphene oxide production process. It's in comparison to other methods, and that leads to a better and more reliable product. Furthermore, we use an optimized fabrication process for use in a microfluidic container, which also leads to a very uniform device characteristics. And we have a very cheap sensor fabrication, which is easily able to large upscale potential. We could use, for example, reel-to-reel production, which makes the process cheaper. And our sensor has a high flexibility. It is easy to adapt. The finished chip to a chip to the target marker, and we can detect multiple biomarkers on one chip. Thank you for your attention. Okay. Okay. So the question was, how cheap the chip can be, and how we can do this in the production process, and so. And we didn't figure out a number because it was still in research, in the research process. But we thought that we have not such a complicated process, so everyone who has a clean room can do our process. And so we used less as a base, but it's not said that we need to use less. We could also use some other material or think about that and do some more research about that. And for example, we could also use a flexible material and then to do this reel-to-reel production so that the process and the chip itself gets cheaper. Yeah. So, any other questions? No? Okay.
Yes, thank you. Thank you very much for the presentation.